Hello everyone. In this video, we will discuss advanced matrix operations, okay, using NumPy, okay. And we will also discuss in NumPy there is a module linear algebra, LINALG, okay. We will discuss that. So first, determinant of a matrix, okay. So there is a matrix, we want to calculate determinant of that matrix. So let me take this particular matrix, okay. I want to calculate the determinant. So manually, how I will be calculating? The first element 2, 0 into 5 is 0, minus 4 into minus 1, it's minus 4. So minus into minus plus 4. Then there is a minus. Second element, already there is a minus, so minus into minus plus 3. 2 into 5, 10, minus 1 into 1, 1, plus 1, 2 into 4, 8, minus 1 into 0, 0, okay. So, 4 into 2, it's 8, plus 10 minus 1, 9, 9 into 3, 2 into 5, 10, then mistakenly I took this, so minus 1 into 1, 1 into minus 1, minus 1, so this is plus 1. So 3 into 11, 33, okay, here I made a mistake, I'm sorry. So 1 into 8, 8, okay, so if you add 41, 49, we'll get 49. Okay, so with Python, okay, in NumPy, as I said earlier, there is a special module for linear algebra. So you can access that using numpy.linearalgebra. Okay, numpy.linearalgebra, you can import that DET. So matrix is available in the basic NumPy itself, so directly you can import the matrix, okay. Let us practice this in Python console. So from NumPy, import matrix from numpy dot linear algebra, okay, linear algebra, import determinant, okay. So A is the matrix, so matrix is the keyword. Within that, first row 2, 3, 2, minus 3, 1, 2, minus 3, 1, second row, 2, 0, minus 1, 2, 0, minus 1, third row, 1, 4, 5, 1, 4, 5, okay. So, print determinant of M, DET is the built-in command. DET of A, okay, here A. So we need to get 49. Let us verify this. Yeah, I'm getting 49, okay. So DET of the matrix name, okay, that will give the determinant of the matrix, okay. Then for a square matrix, okay, we know that we can take inverse. It should be a full rank matrix. I'm not going to discuss all those things. I have a simple square matrix. How to find out the inverse of the matrix? Okay, 4, 7, 2, 6 is the square matrix. So, outside 1 over, okay, determinant of this matrix. So, 4, 6, sorry, 24, minus 7, 2, sorry, 14. Okay, I'm going to change the matrix. So, the diagonal elements I'm going to swap. Instead of 4, 6, I'm going to write 6 and So this particular diagonal, I'm going to change only the sign. Okay, this will become minus 7, this will become minus 2. So outside 24 minus 14, it's 10. So each and every element of the matrix I'm going to divide by 10. So I will get 0.6 minus 0.7 minus 0.2. Okay, 0.4. Again, for taking inverse, INV is the built-in command. Okay, which is used to take inverse. Again, that is available in numpy dot linear algebra. Okay, we'll verify this. Let me go for the matrix 4 7 2 6. Second row 2 6. Let me delete other things. Okay, so I'm going to import inverse also. Just do inverse. Okay, inverse of this A. Okay, there is a syntax error. Okay, so if you see this bracket, additional bracket, okay, the closing square bracket, I deleted actually. So now it's correct. So 0.6 minus 0.7 minus 0.2, 0.4. Okay. Then we are going to discuss, okay, some of the basic thing. I have a matrix, okay, I have the matrix A. I know, okay, inverse of that matrix. A inverse, okay. A is the matrix, I know inverse of that matrix. A inverse into A, we know that its identity. Okay. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to verify this. There is a built-in command, all close. Okay. Again, that all close command, that is available in NumPy library. Okay. So already we have discussed in the previous videos, we have discussed how to create a identity matrix. So EYE is the built-in command for creating the identity matrix. So I'm just importing the basic matrix command, I, then all close. Okay, so here one line is missing. This INV, okay, that is available in numpy dot linear algebra. I need to import that INV from that. Okay, so now what I am going to do, this all close actually returns a boolean value. Okay, this is not the exact signature or syntax. Other than this, some tolerance values are also available. The tolerances I am not specifying here. It compares A and B. If they are close, okay, if they are close, then it will return the boolean value as true. Otherwise, it is false. Okay, there are some tolerance values available. Okay, those tolerances, if I don't specify those tolerance values, it will take a default tolerance value. So what I am doing, I am just creating a A matrix. A inverse matrix, already we have done this. I'm going to multiply A inverse with A. Okay, then what I'm going to do, I'm going to create a identity matrix of length M. Okay, so it will create a identity matrix of size 2 by 2. Okay, again length is a keyword. Okay, so I'm going to compare A inverse A with the identity matrix. If they are same, it means that A inverse A, if it produces I, both are same, then it will return true. Okay, let us try this. I have A inverse. Okay, I don't want to print this. Instead, what I am doing, let me calculate IA, which is inverse of A. Okay. I'm going to use all close. All close. So I'm going to multiply A I A star A. Okay. I'm going to create a identity matrix of length A. Okay. So now I'm going to close this. Yeah, I think that's all. A matrix, IA matrix, I'm multiplying IA with A. So this will give you identity matrix. I have generated another identity matrix using the built-in command. Okay, that I is not available, so I'm just importing I. All close. Okay, let me try this. You just see it is giving true. Okay, it is giving true. I can also try A inverse. So that is also true. Okay. So through this example, we understood A inverse A is equal to A inverse is equal to I. This we verified using the all close command. Okay. Then we are going to discuss the basic eigenvalue. Okay, eigenvalue decomposition. So I'm going to take some example. Eigenvalue decomposition. Okay, and we are going to use the Python. Okay, I'm going to show how Python is efficient very quickly, how we can get the eigenvalues and eigenvectors. Okay, so eigenvalues and eigenvectors. Okay, so some square matrix A into V is equal to lambda into V, where V is, okay, where V is eigenvector okay, lambda is eigenvalue, A is the square matrix. Okay, so let me take a simple square matrix. A is equal to minus 6, 3, 4 and 5. Okay, in order to find the eigen values, okay, we know that we need to do determinant of A minus lambda into I, where I is the identity matrix. This should be equal to 0. So determinant, okay, I'll write in steps 6 minus 6 3 4 and 5 minus lambda. We know identity matrix, it is 1 0 0 1. Determinant that is equal to 0. So this is equal to minus 6 minus lambda 3. Okay. So next one is 4, then 5 minus lambda. Okay. This is equal to 0. Because when I multiply lambda with 0 and this 0, I will get 0, only the diagonal elements it affects. Okay. Now, simplify this, find out the determinant, minus 6 minus lambda into 5 minus lambda minus 3 into 4, it is 12, this is equal to 0. Simplify this, minus 6 into 5 minus 30 minus into minus plus 6 lambda minus 5 lambda minus into minus plus lambda square minus 12 is equal to 0. So lambda square, 6 lambda minus 5 lambda, it is lambda. Okay, minus 30 minus minus 12, it is minus 42. Okay, we need to solve for lambda. This is a quadratic equation. Okay, we can use that minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. If you solve that, you will get two values for lambda. One is 6, another one is minus 7. Okay, so these are the eigenvalues. Okay. For these eigenvalues, what are the eigenvectors that we need to find out? So let me try with lambda equal to 6. We know that A matrix into V vector is lambda into V vector. So A matrix is minus 6, 3, 4 and 5. Okay, into V vector. I don't know this vector, this I have to find out. Let me call the entries x and y. Okay, that is equal to lambda, just now we got it is 6 into the vector x1. We need to find out this x and y. So let us multiply this. Minus 6x plus 3y is equal to 6x. Second row, 4x plus 5y is equal to 6y. Okay, so if you take this 6x to the other side, I will get 3y is equal to 12x. If I divide by 3, y is equal to 4x. In the same way here, 4x is equal to, okay, 4x is equal to 6y minus 5y, it is y. So both are same. So you can give some x value. Suppose let me take x equal to minus 1, then y equal to, okay, minus 4. So the eigenvector minus 1 comma minus 4. Okay, in the same fashion for lambda equal to 6. Sir, lambda equal to minus 7. Okay. So what I am going to do, the same thing. A into V vector is equal to lambda into V vector. A value is minus 6, 3, 4 and 5. This is multiplied with V vector, which I don't know. Let me write x and y. The present lambda value is minus 7 multiplied by the vector x1. It enters x1. Simplify this. Minus 6x plus 3y is equal to minus 7x. 4x plus 5y is equal to minus 7. Okay. So simplify this. 3y minus 7x plus 6x, it's minus 6. Okay. So this is one thing. Y equal to minus 1 by 3 into x. The same way here also. 4x. Okay. Minus 7y minus 5y, it's minus 12y. If you divide by 4, x is equal to minus 3 times y. So y is equal to minus 1 by 3x. Suppose if you substitute x equal to minus 1, you will get y equal to 1 by 3. Okay, y equal to 1 by 3. So the eigen vectors are minus 1 comma, this is my V vector. Okay, this is my V vector. So I took some example and I got the eigenvalues and eigenvectors. In the next video, what I will do, I will directly go for the Python in one or two lines, okay, in one or two lines by using some built-in commands. You can very easily get these answers, okay. So this will show the efficiency of the NumPy, okay. I'll stop here.